The third brand new ZX Spectrum from all newish parts is going to be this variant on the Harlequin 128 by the genius that is Don Superfo. The big deal about these recreated versions of the venerable Spectrums is how they use off-the-shelf, readily available new chips to replace the custom chip in the ZX Spectrum series, known as the ULA, or Uncommitted Logic Array. The earlier Harlequins used good old 74 series logic chips. Lots of them. Seriously, look at all of them. There were so many on those boards that they even hid some under the other chips. Much as I admire the engineering that led to this brilliant little board with all its silicon, I have to also admire the mind that looked at this, what most would consider a finished project, and said, yeah, we can do that better. The ZX Max 128 is the result. And one thing you might notice on this board compared to its older brother, the Harlequin 128K, is how few chips there are, or will be. All of the logic, and not just the ULA, but all the logic dealing with memory too, all of it is now handled by this Altera Max EPM7128S, hence the name. A CPLD, or a complex programmable logic device, is another type of logic IC, this one containing enough programmable logic to incorporate all of the logic in the ZX Harlequin 128K in this one single chip. What's that? That one there? Oh yeah, that's a logic chip. Why didn't they incorporate that into the CPLD? Good question. Not one I can answer. Go do your own research. This board was very kindly donated to the fundraising cause by a great pal of the channel, Julian. We're raising money for the Befriending Scheme, and once this is built and hopefully all working, I'll package this up in a custom flight case with some extra goodies, and it'll be auctioned off along with the other machines, including the lovely ZX Spectrum with the Harlequin 128K and the beautiful smoke translucent new build OG ZX Spectrum 48K. There are at least four Spectrums going up for auction, with the final day's bidding happening on the 16th of September. I'll be hosting a 12-hour live stream, and the auctions will be set to end throughout the day. I'll also be joined by 11 amazing special guests to have a chat with and keep me awake. Put the day in your diary, it's gonna be fun. Back to the ZX Max. We have the board and the CPLD, which I'm told is the very tricky bit to source, and Neal from the NLK Media YouTube channel very kindly went through the bill of materials and put together almost all the parts I would need. The few bits missing I already have, apart from the sound chip and this diode package up here. Julian has stepped up once more and offered to send both of those parts to me. You've seen me soldering components into things before. I'll keep this part of the video brief and just get it built. How about a fancy wipe? That sounds wrong. And there it mostly is. I did have to drill a hole in the back of the case for the reset button, but that's okay, this isn't an original case. The whole thing was really easy to build, thanks in part to Neal bagging up the components with all the positions labelled on the bags, and also to the simplicity of this compared to the full-blown chip fest of the Harlequin 128K. I have one component left to install, this jack here, which has taken an ages to arrive through the post, and then this is finished. Lie mode, and it was all plain sailing with no hitches whatsoever. Oh, you want to know about the problems. What's that? That's your favourite bit? Masochists. Okay, so this is what actually happened. I finished soldering the parts, and the last job I needed to do before I could insert all the chips into their sockets was to program the CPLD. This is something I've not done myself, not counting a PyStorm, which is basically programming itself. I purchased a programmer, downloaded the Intel Quartus 2 software, and learned how to make a CPLD be a ULA and the other chips by Googling and reading. Now for my moaning old man bit. The Harlequin kit you get from Ben at Byte Delight is truly a wonderful thing, with perfect instructions and components all laid out for you in a very easy to follow fashion. Very little can go wrong. That is a far cry from what you'll experience if you want to build the ZX Max 128. All the things you need are there, but there are no instructions. Not even bad ones. And for the most part, you don't really need them. If you order a board from your favourite PCB maker, download the bill of materials from the GitHub page, and order all of the parts, putting all of that together is actually fairly intuitive. The board is marked clearly, and it's pretty easy to build, but at that point, you're on your own. On the GitHub, There really are no instructions on how to program a CPLD or even a link to another site showing the process. I had to rely on the kindness of Julian, who donated this board and chip, so it's kind of his fault anyway, to give me some loose instructions on how he did it a couple of years ago. I followed those instructions, downloading the POF file from GitHub, installing the CPLD in the socket, connecting the programmer to the board with this handy header, powering the board and pressing program in quarters. But no, the software insisted something was wrong and used language I didn't understand. It was a super frustrating few days trying to troubleshoot something I've no previous experience with. Everything seemed to be correct. The board was powered, the chip was in the right way, and my soldering was adequate. It could only really be the CPLD. Julian had a crack at programming one of the chips from the batch he'd sent me, and it turns out that the whole batch was behaving in exactly the same way. They all refused to program, and one of them even turned into its own tiny hot plate. This is a big problem when buying CPLDs right now. With the scarcity and value of these things increasing in recent times, the chances of getting some fakes are sadly relatively high. After a couple of days, a package arrived from Julian with the pre-programmed CPLD clearly marked, an extra blank one, and the rest of the batch of fakes. I popped the blank chip into the board, connected the programmer, and clicked the button. It didn't work. It was the same as before. Mildly disappointed I wouldn't get to program a chip, I resigned myself to using the one that was already programmed. Perhaps my programmer was faulty, or something else with my setup was part of the problem. I popped that marked chip into the board, installed all the other chips, switched it on, and it didn't work. Power was getting to the board, there was a clock coming out of both crystals, but nothing was getting to the CPU. Now, on a normal spectrum, that situation would point directly at the ULA being at fault. The clock goes through the ULA, and if that's faulty, it doesn't come back out the other side. In this case, the ULA is the CPLD chip. So my first thought was that's the problem. Around that time, Julian messaged me and said he might have sent me the wrong chip. He had two boards and one was programmed and one was not, and the unprogrammed one might have been sent by mistake. I had one more thing I could try. I connected the programmer to the board with what I suspected was a blank chip installed, plugged it into my PC and hit program. And it only worked. Excited, I rushed over to the bench and connected it up, switched it on, and it works. Phew. That was quite a journey and actually great fun despite the setbacks. This case was another item donated to the fundraising by Neal from NLK Media. His chosen colour scheme of orange and black is quite striking. And I'm done. That was a great fun build, and I'm very tempted to make one of these for myself one day. This machine will be up for auction finishing on the 16th of September, when I will be live streaming for 12 hours and joined by some very special super guests from the world of YouTube. If you'd like to help with the fundraising, please consider making a donation on the Just Giving page, which will be linked in the description. Thank you to Julian and Neil for your help with this build. I would truly have been lost without you both. And thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.